We all know that hello world is not a valid HTML tag, but what if it could be? Let's hop over here and create an Angular module called components, just to make it super generic, and create our first directive. We're going to name this directive hello world camel cased. You'll notice over here hello world is dash spaced, so it's always camel cased dash space. Good way to remember it. And then in here, if you've ever read the Angular docs, this can get a bit confusing. It talks about compile phase, a link phase, a pre-link, and a post-link, different restrictions and transclusion, and kind of goes on and on about all these different scenarios of managing scope and whatnot. I'm just going to do the most simple thing and skip over all of that. Instead, just restrict this to being an element, meaning that this is an element, it's not an attribute, it's not a comment, and it's not a class. So it's an element, just capital E. And then set up a template, which is just going to be a span of hello world. Now if I refresh this now, nothing happens. That's simply because we haven't set up our ng app yet. Let's point this to hello app and hop over to our directives file and set up another module and call it hello app. Now if I refresh now, nothing's happening, but if I pass in components and refresh, you see we have it, our hello world component displaying hello world. And that's because our hello app depends on the components. The components has a directive of hello world, which has a restriction of element, which is an element, and then a template of span and hello world. Seems to make a lot of sense. Let's take it another step further here. We'll grab this template and open up our Angular directives directory, create another one, call it partials, and in our partials directory, we'll create an HTML file and call it hello. Now we'll paste our template in here, and I think you may see where this is going if I name this template URL instead. We'll do hello.html. Hit refresh and it magically works. Just to show it doesn't work, if you remove the L, put the L back in, and it works. Now, you don't always just want to say hello to the world. Sometimes you'll want to say hello to someone else. In this case, I'll say hello to myself. I'm a nice guy, you know, why not? And then I'll try and bind to that name that I'm passing in. So let's say name. If I hit refresh now, I refreshed inside of the wrong HTML file. So if I hit refresh now, it's just going to say hello and nothing because it can't find that name. But if I go into my directive here and I expose the name through the scope and I say, hey name, I want to bind to you, and then refresh, you'll see it says hello John Lindquist. So I set up an attribute over here of name. And then in my directive, I added it to the scope of something that it can be bound to. And then in the template, I exposed it as something that's going to show up whenever that changes on the scope. So that's the basics of a directive. There's much, much more to go into get into here, but I'm just going to leave it at that for this one. Just to recap, we set up our hello world here, which is in our directive of hello world. This is wrapped inside of a components, which we passed into our hello app, which is instantiated here. So hello app, components, components, hello world, hello world. Then for our directive object, we restricted it to element. So that's our element. Use the scope to expose name. There's our name, we bound to that, passed in John Lindquist, which shows up here. And then finally, this is just pointing the template URL to the hello.html. Hopefully that makes sense. I'll definitely go into more detail in future tutorials. And thanks for watching.